So here we'll see how to convert this map into a list. To convert this, we'll have a function like this. Now this function has two return statements. First return statement points to this map over here, and map has a property which is called entries, and entries has another property which is called map. So now we'll use this entries.map to access the each of the elements inside this map. Now E over here, it refers to this row. So it would go through like a for loop, and each time it loop through, it will get each of them. And then we are extracting the value from each of this row. So this is a map. So this is the key and this is the value. Key, value. So each time in the loop, we are getting the value and putting them in a list using this one. We can print it by calling the name of this function. So here we say string 1, string 2, string 3, which corresponds to this one. Now instead of getting the value, each time we loop through, we can get the key 1, 2, 3. These are the keys. So we can go ahead and print the keys. Now another form of this function is this one, just writing one single line where using. Now another form of this function is this line. So here we are using arrow function two times. Now these two arrow functions over here corresponds to the return statement here with this one over here, and this return corresponds to this one over here. Now if we run, we'll see the exact same, even though the function, they look quite different. Yes, 1, 2, 3. So because of this one, it returns a list to you. Now with this, you can mention the index. Now here index 1 refers to this line, 0, 1, this line. Now if we run it, we'll see string 2. Yes, so that's how it works.